special Christmas show this year, 2021. Unfortunately, Irma cannot be with me as we record this opening because she's with family and it's a very important matters, but we wanted to get an opening recorded. Fred has discovered our Christmas show from 1991, would have been our third Christmas show. This originated from the Paulsboro VFW. Now, you see how I appear today, by the way, against this backdrop of model trains, which is so much about the Christmas spirit. But we'll see what my appearance looks like 30 years ago. Now, I want to give you a bit of a rundown because maybe you want to call a neighbor or friend to let them know these people are going to be on, because some of these dear friends are a little hard to get a hold of on most occasions. So we're at the Paulsboro VFW, which in fact no longer is there. And we have special guests that include Kid Primo, who was just a wonderful friend. My father, as he was mayor, giving a proclamation. We have greetings from various ministers, including Richard Kenzinger from the Taylor Memorial Baptist Church. That's no longer functioning as the Taylor Memorial Baptist Church. Bob Reed, a dear friend who ran the VFW, he joins us. We have also Thomas White, St. Paul's United Methodist Church, served a wonderful term as pastor there. And Jeanne Giampola, who was recently in the headlines with the advocacy of Lenny Curtis to get the overpass on Billingsport Road named after her, and that group of women that led the fight to get that, including Irma. Jeanne joins us along with Tony Gentile. Of course, Tony's still alive. Jeanne, unfortunately, has passed away. And the Andrews sisters. Now, this is an interesting group because you'll recognize them when you look closely. It's John Flemming, John Rastelli, and Win Mattson doing the Andrews sisters, as politically incorrect as it could possibly be by today's standards. We also have Reverend Hamilton, who led the Faith Tabernacle Church for so many years. Joe Giovanetti, of course, is still with us with a cooking segment. It's going to be a lot of fun because the recipes are as new today as they were then. John Carrow, who was a Billingsport Fire Company at the time. Reverend Fraser is still running Second Baptist Church. He may look a little bit younger. Doris Rink, of course, is still with us with the Gibbstown Historical Commission. We have a thread of the Senior Citizen Kazoo Band led by Marion, Martino. Now, that was a spirited group. My grandmother was in that for a while as well. Also, greetings from Reverend Berdanga. He's still with us, of course. And a visit by Chuck Quackenbush and Judy Gazzara, who are both still with us at that time, giving thank yous for the Christmas parade. We think you're going to enjoy this. We weren't in a position to do a new show this year, so we thought the best thing to do was take a comfortable look back. So this is a look back 30 years. This is a time capsule. I on Paulsboro Christmas show from the Paulsboro VFW. We hope you enjoy it, and Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to everyone on behalf of myself and Irma and Fred Buchter and Amy Buchter and our producer, Bill Crane, who couldn't be with us today. Again, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and we hope to see you in the new year with a new series of shows. Stand by for that announcement. Thank you. Oh, let me say, see you on Broad Street, Irma would insist.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one horse open sleigh.
Hi, welcome to I Own Paulsboro, another special Christmas show, and again this year we've been invited back to the VFW. It's such a warm and kind place to be. And that music, the opening of the show, is the Senior Citizens Kazoo Band under the direction of Marion Martino and many of our friends in the group. We're going to have a fun program, many guests, a lot of footage. Bill has been all over town with the camera. Nice stories, and we hope you'll enjoy the show. And as usual with the Christmas show, there'll probably be a little bit of the unexpected as well. Stay with us. We're on Commerce Street in Paulsboro from the VFW. Marion, a little bit of music. We're going to go to our first commercial, and we're going to be right back.
Avoid a holiday headache. Make your party shopping a one-stop project at Morta's Bakery and Deli.
For the best hoagies anywhere, Morta's Bakery and Deli in Paulsboro. Baking Forelli's breads and putting together the most delicious sandwiches anywhere. It's more than a claim. When you taste Boar's Head quality, you'll know what we mean.
Call now and order your party trays, gift boxes, stolen fresh baked bread and rolls. Morta's Bakery and Deli on Broad Street in Paulsboro, across from Ames.
John J. Burzichelli, for 23 years of service to the borough of Paulsboro as a councilman, president of council, and as mayor, December 17, 1991. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And with that presentation marks the end of an era of sorts. My father served as mayor for 16 years, our municipality's 17th mayor, finishes his term, and many memories, of course. And he joins me now, along with our whole group here at the VFW, to bring us Christmas greetings from the official borough family and to share a moment with us. He's still mayor till December 31st. Dad, welcome. This is the third Christmas show.
John, thanks for having me.
You're in early on the show, so it's there's still some semblance of order to it.
Well, I'm looking at the coffee. I haven't tasted it.
Looks pretty good myself. Should have caught me on that one. Dad, you're finishing as mayor, but you're still mayor. So how about a Christmas greeting on behalf of the...
Well, John, I'd just like to not only wish everybody a very, very Merry Christmas and a very successful and prosperous Happy New Year, but... You know, take this opportunity along to say thank you for letting me be your mayor for the last 16 years. I've considered it a great honor and a privilege. And I just want to go out on a nice way and just say, you know, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Well, that's greatly appreciated. You certainly made your family and the people around you very proud. And you set quite an example for those that follow. And we certainly wish that Jim, who's now going to be our mayor on January 1, when he finishes as mayor, that he gets to leave office with as much respect and dignity and admiration as you're leaving with. So we send you with those wishes.
I thank you very much. Of course, my son, too, on top of it.
Thank you, Dad. That's Mayor Burzichelli with a Christmas greeting, and as we continue with the flow of the show. We're going to come right back. Marion, how about a little bit of kazoo music? Kid Primo's with us now, and on we go with the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am the Reverend Richard Kensinger from Taylor Memorial Baptist Church, the little church on the corner of Greenwich and 7th Avenue, right across from the high school. I bring you greetings from my church. I'd like to invite you or any of you to come out to join us on our Christmas Eve service, which begins at 7 o'clock p.m., of course, on the 24th. It is a candlelight service and is always very special, a tradition at our church, and beautiful. We would welcome any visitors. Also, I'm speaking to you from the Paulsboro High School on Wednesday evening, the 18th, where we are now in process of sharing our community Christmas service. As chairman and general secretary of the Paulsboro Ministerium, I hope many of you who did not come this year will remember next year to come out and join us. We're having a great time. God bless you.
Thinking about a GE appliance or TV? Don't think twice. Think Weiss. Weiss True Value, Gloucester County's longest established GE dealer. Weiss has a complete line of GE appliances and TVs, along with hardware items like True Test paints, Master Mechanics tools, and electrical supplies. And for repairs on screens and windows, look no further. Weiss True Value, from making keys to selling TVs. Don't think twice, think Weiss. 39 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
Hi, welcome back once again. And what a pleasant time we're having. The Senior Citizen Kazoo Band, pleasure having my father on, and a lot of friends in the audience. And now Kid Primo joins us in the background here. Welcome, Dominic.
Thank you.
And he has a night off because we have the Andrew Sisters coming. We've got a special show for you. But with me now is Bob Reed, who's a dear friend and also is commander of this post. And if I'm not mistaken, Bob, you're going to be district commander. Are you coming up on it shortly? Or
in June.
Coming up on June.
Yes.
And we were here last year. If you remember, the circumstances were a great deal different.
Right.
The yellow ribbons every place, the concern going on with overseas. But this year, we sort of have a different focus. First, thank you for having us in, because you know we always love the VFW.
My pleasure, John, to have you on Channel 5. And I have Paulsboro at our post here. It's really a welcome to have you here.
The best coffee in town, too. You know?
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
But we try to please.
You do, too. This year we mark the 50th anniversary of the Pearl Harbor.
That's the fact.
And a lot of veterans are of that age range in World War II that had a lot of personal experience with it. And for those of us who were too young and have a great, and owe a great deal to those who served, we like to take time to mark it as well. So tell us about the ceremony. We have some footage as you're speaking.
It was a great honor for me to hold a ceremony on Memorial Day of December 7th, where our departed comrades that lost their lives during the attack on Pearl Harbor. Now, we had all 19 posts from Gloucester County there, plus we had the American Legion Honor Guard from Pittman, New Jersey, and we had the Navy Garrison Club from National Park was there with their Honor Guard. And it went real nice. We had some local politicians there, and the whole ceremony lasted about an hour. Now, we're going to continue this now for every year. This was our first year to do this. But we're going to do this every year now on December 7th at National Park.
It was very impressive. John Mayer spoke, Gary Stahltreger spoke, Freeholder Jim Axon spoke, I noticed, yourself as well, and I think particularly the placing of the wreath to the passing waters was really quite an emotional moment.
Yeah, well, we hope next year to have some survivors from there to be there next year. We started out a little late this year. We were first, like I said, this was our first year doing it, and there was other places that was having these ceremonies, and we just couldn't get no survivors there to speak, you know. So next year we're hoping to have some survivors there with us. We're going to start out in July and start our committee up and start it going and have it ready by December 7th.
Wonderful, Bob. That's Bob Reed. He's commander here and soon to be district commander for the post in our region. And a big thank you to Bob and all the members here at the VFW for having us in, and especially the VFW hosting us after the 4th of July parade, making us feel so much at home. Marion, can we have a little quick kazoo? Kid Primo's here, and we're going to come right back. We have a few Christmas greetings and some church information coming up following a little bit of kazoo music. Marion?
Reverend Thomas White from St. Paul's United Methodist Church in Paulsboro, wishing each and every one of you a blessed Christmas and a happy, most meaningful new year. We wish to welcome you to this special services of St. Paul's United Methodist Church on Tuesday evening, Christmas Eve, at 7:30. A family service for all ages.
Brearley Painting Service and Appliance Break, your one-stop redecorating companies. For three generations, Brearley Painting Service has been painting interiors and exteriors of homes and commercial buildings throughout the Delaware Valley. Sandblasting service is available, including truck and heavy-duty equipment refinishing. Appliance Bright will transform your dull, drab kitchen and bathroom into a bright new look by refinishing your appliances, cabinets, bathtubs. Also, they specialize in refinishing office furniture and laboratory equipment. No job too big or too small. Call for a free estimate.
Hi, we're back once again. You know, in this Christmas season, so many are so fortunate to have so much, and then a select group becomes fortunate to give so much. With me now is Jeanne Giampola, and of course you know her as councilperson, and Jeanne's been so active in the community. I'm surrounded by so many people here, Tony Gentile, and I always forget these names going down. And
Edie Thayer.
Thank you.
Fee McCall.
Okay.
Mrs. Erickson. This one I know because my granddaughter, Brittany McCall Giampola.
This is Sarah Ferran, Brittany Erickson, Jamie Alexander, Kristen Loader, and Carrie Hinman.
Boy, it's a lovely group. And Jeanne's going to tell us about a project that's been ongoing that benefits the whole community and makes us all proud. Jeanne, how about a quick rundown?
All right. About 2 weeks ago, we asked, it came to our attention that because of the hard economic times, that some people were having a choice between paying their mortgages and putting food on the table and possibly not being able to give their children a toy. It was a feeling of several of us ladies that every child is entitled to at least one toy at Christmas. So we put our heads together, we put a plea out to the community. The Brownies are here because they've been exceptionally helpful to us. Tony Gentile, who's also the borough foreman, has been the best gopher you, if you ever need a gopher, Tony runs. I mean, you call him up, you call him at home, you call him anytime and say, hey, somebody wants to donate this, go get it. Tony says, yeah, let me put my pants on, I'm going. You know?
At least, at least we got him putting his pants on now.
At least he isn't running out without him.
That's correct.
But he's, Bee's been taking all the calls, Edie's. You'd be surprised. I think you'll have maybe some pictures of all the toys and the gifts that were donated to the children. So Saturday, your show will be aired by them. Between 1 and 3, we're going to give the children their toys so that we hope not to miss anybody, and we're hoping every child in Paulsboro does have a toy.
Jeanne, it's wonderful. There really is a Santa Claus.
Yes, there is.
Yes, there is. Thank
yes,
you, one
is.
And all. Thank you, one and all. That deserves a round of applause from everybody here. We're going to go to commercial. A little bit of music. Yep.
All right.
On behalf of everybody here from Just For You Sports, I'd like to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas and a very prosperous New Year. Right, Darren?
Yes, sir.
Located just around the corner in Paulsboro, it's Just For You Sports Boutique.
We have whatever you need, from school jackets to gym bags. We also have a large line of pro and college sweats, tees, and hats. Also, customized hats as well as silk screening to order. Just For You Sports Boutique also carries top-name sportswear and accessories. Just For You Sports Boutique has just what you're looking for, so just stop by. The Paulsboro Plaza in Paulsboro. Call 423-8291.
You know, our Christmas show has traditionally had a surprise or two, going back over the years. But this may be the biggest surprise of all, and possibly the most fun. We're going to ask for a warm round of applause from our large crowd here as we welcome to our show, the VFW, the Andrews Sisters. Mrs. Tedeschi? Can you imagine? Should we have an encore? Should we have an encore? Ladies, are you prepared to do one more for us? What a beautiful group. Here we are, the Andrews Sisters, and a Merry Christmas. Ladies. A big bow. That's the Andrews Sisters. John Flemming, John Rastelli, Mr. Mattson.
Win Mattson.
What a show. Thank you so very much. What a beautiful group of girls. We're going to come right back with another segment of the show. They are just lovely. I can't tell you. Merry Christmas. We'll be right back.
We come tonight to greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to wish everyone a Merry Christmas. And we are happy to be here on our second annual program here for the ministerial. And we thank God for all that have came out tonight to enjoy this program. May the Lord ever bless you. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We at Landolfi Funeral Home would like you to know that we are available in your time of need 24 hours a day. With owner Frank and associates Robert and Robert D. Landolfi, Landolfi Funeral Home has been serving all faiths in Gloucester County for over 30 years. Landolfi Funeral Home, 300 West Broad Street, Paulsboro, 423-0519.
Hi, did you really think we could have a Christmas show without having Joe Giovanetti join us with another one of his absolutely wonderful tips? Joe, welcome to the show. It's your third time. The second time at the VFW.
Well, last
time
I was going to be here
for this deal. Why don't we just get right into it? Because
okay, John. Well, we're going to try to save time again, like we do every year.
Yeah, well, Bob Reed make you a cup of coffee?
I've got a cup of the special coffee here.
Yes, thank you, Bob Reed.
It's very strong coffee. Anyway, I think what we'll make this year, John, is something that goes over very big at every party. I mean, you can put out all kind of fancy hors d'oeuvres at a party, but it seems like whenever there's stromboli bread or broccoli bread or pepperoni bread or whatever you want to call it, that's what always goes first and everybody seems to grab for.
Okay.
So, John, what we're going to do is I have some fresh dough that we're going to let you roll out.
Oh, that's a real adventure, Jeff. Yeah. Because so I'm thinking of what I usually grab for at parties.
What we're going to do is you can get this kind of fresh dough. Either you can use frozen bread dough from a supermarket, or you can get it at, here's your plug, Nate.
Go ahead, Nate.
Mortis Bakery.
One of our sponsors. Thank you, Nate.
And, John, I just want you to roll that out so that it looks somewhat like this.
We're all noticing I'm rolling the dough out.
You want to roll from the center to the end. You're already messing up, John. Okay. This way,
that's
and
good,
then
Jeff.
That way.
That's good.
And
that's
this
good.
Way, and that way, this way, that way. Okay?
You got a real chance of that happening,
okay.
Joe.
Okay.
Can we move quickly?
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay.
How quick we got to move?
My grandmother would never approve of such a thing.
Can't anyway, you, while he's rolling that,
can't you buy this already done?
Can we get a camera on this one here?
Now he's directing, John. Did you hear that? Can he get a camera? Bill, are you hearing that?
I need a camera right now.
He's got 6 minutes for the whole segment. He's asking for a camera.
Okay,
it's a red light,
anyway,
Joe.
What we're going to do
light.
Is we're going to make two types of this bread. One is going to be the traditional pepperoni and cheese mozzarella. But another one is you can take broccoli and saute it in a little garlic and olive oil.
I hope you're not waiting on this, Joe.
And just drain a lot of the oil off so that it's not too runny, and we're going to put it right over top of the bread here, the rolled out dough.
How late's McDonald's open?
Then we're going to top it with some mozzarella cheese, freshly shredded. I'm going to save some cheese here for John. And what you're going to do is you're going to take
can't
it.
Have cheese,
this sounds
Joe,
pretty easy.
Fat.
All my Italian friends are going to say, Joe, we know how to make that already, so, you know, what are you wasting my time for? But some of the unlucky non-Italians might not know how to make it. Here we go.
That thought never entered my mind, Joe.
Well, anyway, here we go.
Am I going to end up wearing this thing?
You're going to take it and you're going to start. Can you guys see this?
Oh, of course, John.
We've got to invest in a mirror that will show this.
Did you hear that, John?
Anyway, we're
going to
roll it over. John's already ready to quit.
I'm not ready to quit. I'm having a great
no, not
time.
Not you, John Mondelli. We're going to roll it. We're going to roll it over here like this, and you're going to take a little bit of water, which we have here in our handy sink, and run it across there like that, and that'll help the dough stick together.
But you know,
okay,
John Mondelli.
Move. We're going to move it here, and we're going to pinch the ends like this. You can even take it, since it's Christmas, and roll it like this and put it on a greased baking pan and shoot it into the oven on about 400 degrees until it's brown.
And here's what it looks like when you finish.
Here's what they look like. Yeah. Here's what they, John, you're really, anyway, here's what they look like when they're finished.
So
nice,
cool.
Brown. Broccoli, cheese inside, and this is a pepperoni. We'll cut that up later, and the crew and the gang here can feast on it.
I like that, Joe.
All right, and then okay. What we're going to make also is...
Now, what do I do with this?
Well, you could do a number of things with this. Use your imagination. Anyway, what we're going to make now is... how much time I got here?
Keep rolling.
3 minutes? Okay. We're going to make stuffed mushroom caps.
I don't think John
with
Mondelli
crab meat.
His hair, do you, Joe? Do you think John Mondelli tints his hair?
I don't know. This is my segment.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay, anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to take some fresh crab meat. Well, fresh. It was fresh until it went into the can, okay?
Okay,
canned
so crab
meat.
Meat.
We're going to take an egg. We're going to put an egg in here.
A raw egg, Joe?
A raw egg, well, because you're going to cook them.
It all smells
good
so
far. A little parsley and garlic combination here, which we make everything with. A little salt, a little pepper.
Now, do I need a rolling pin any longer?
No, no. And a little bit of breadcrumb. Yeah. But you can do this for me, John. You can mix that up by hand. You got to use your hands because that won't work.
Yeah.
And then after it, yeah, mix it. Let's go. All right. Let's go.
I'm not going to make any comments, Joe. Oh, that my.
Smell won't offend you. Come on, let's
won't
go.
Won't offend me.
No. A little crab. Little...
Yeah.
Here we go. What you're going to do is you're going to put the, after you mix that up, that's pretty well there mixed.
Okay.
You're going to spoon these mushroom caps full of this stuff here, and then you're going to shoot them into an oven and bake them until they're browned, which would take about 10 minutes.
And Joe,
in
what?
An oven of about 400 degrees.
And if we had done that, what would they look like?
If we did that through the magic of television, here they are. You could set them on a tray. They go over real big at your party. They're always the first thing to get to grab. And
no, Joe, you said the pepperoni bread was the first thing to grab.
Well, this is the second thing.
Second.
Okay. That was
the second thing.
If you haven't voted, that's the second thing.
Now, what happens with this here? I'm going to have to take a shower now.
Now, you're right.
Janice
okay.
is never going to believe
now,
me when I get home.
Here's the big thing here. This is something new here.
Well,
it's new to me anyway. What we're going to do is we're going to make
towel?
A punch bowl out of a huge block of ice.
We're going to make a punch bowl out of a huge block of
ice. Can you guys see
ice.
This? Here?
Joe, I'm going down here quick.
Who's this? Where should I show this?
The red light, Joe. The red light.
Okay, the red light. Here we go.
Once a year, Joe comes on. Once a year.
What we have is a
this
is a 25-pound block of ice that you can get anywhere.
Anywhere Ames.
Anyway, and I bought this today on the coldest day of the year. I looked really crazy. And what you're going to do is you're going to take a You're going to take a knife or an ice pick and chip away at it until you get a little depression in here. And you're going to take a pot like this and set it on top and pour boiling hot water into the pot. And it eventually will keep on melting, and then you keep dumping the water that melted from the ice until you eventually get down about that deep. Okay, and then what you're going to do is you're going to take some punch. You pour your punch in, and you pour a little bit of your Caesar's Palace Pocono champagne that we got here up in the Caesar's Palace Resort.
Can you imagine?
My wife doesn't know I'm dumping it in here, but here we go.
Alcoholic beverages on a set of Ion Paulsboro Christmas show.
Can you believe that?
Out of character. No, I can't believe
anyway,
it for a second. Did
here
you hear
we
that, Bob Reed?
Can someone give me a cup here? We're going to try a cup of this Christmas cheer.
Give me two cups. I'm not allowed to drink on the set this year. Bill Crane insisted that we
This does look, a little champagne. Here you go, John.
All right, Joe.
Want to try it out?
Yeah. Shall we?
Tenton.
It's very good.
There you go.
That's Joe Giovanetti, Giovanetti Caterers, and a dear friend. We've had many dear friends this evening, but we continue with that, and certainly a good sport.
Merry Christmas, Elena, Bo, and Joey.
Got it all in, didn't he? Got it all in. We went from crabs to punch. Thank you, Joe. We're going to come right back
Anyone?
After this word, and a Merry Christmas to Joe. See you in a moment or two, if we're allowed.
Giovanetti Catering is proud of the personal care we take in everything we do. We use only the highest quality ingredients in our hot entrees, freshly made salads, vegetable dishes, and hors d'oeuvres. Birthdays, showers, anniversaries, pig roasts, from the most elaborate buffet to a simple office luncheon. Giovanetti Catering makes your occasion a pleasure. And future newlyweds, our beautiful bridal plans are second to none and priced to fit your budget. Need a hall, DJ, band, or limo? Leave it all to us. Giovanetti Catering, any occasion a pleasure.
Hi, and welcome back once again. We're having a fun time at the VFW. I don't know that we can top the Andrews Sisters, Irma.
I can't even top them in all the costumes I would ever wear, John. They were great.
And Dominic, have you ever seen three prettier ladies?
Oh, they were beautiful. They were.
It's a shame you're married. Yeah, it's a shame you're married.
That's right.
We're going to start with community notes. We've got a lot of footage. Irma, why don't you lead off?
John, happy birthday. And this is December. A lot of people get gypped with their birthday presents. Justin Eaton, he's the grandson of the Morrises from Gibbstown. And they're taping this and sending it to Florida. I am Paul's going to be in Florida. And they're one of our faithful viewers.
It's pretty scary.
Aunt Bert.
You know, there's mayor laws.
Right. Aunt Bert. Aunt Bert's cleaners. It's her birthday.
Did Aunt Bert say how old she was?
22 and holding, Joe.
I thought so.
Renee Morris is the prettiest nurse in Underwood ER. Their business has boomed since she's been there. Dee Falcone, William Cammon, Phyllis Antonelli, Pat Moran, Jamie Sabetta, Larry Moran, Joe Long, former councilman, Don Doak Jr., Gladys Walker, Joey Doak, and Jim Johnson. His family's here, and they're going to send this tape to Germany, John. We're getting all over with Luther Yarborough and Brittany Giampola. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, guys.
Yes, and an added birthday to my brother Robert, and I'm going to jump right in here with direct reading while we have footage to go. The senior citizens who are doing so much to make this Christmas show very special with the Kazoo Band and the Andrews Sisters held their annual Christmas dinner party at the Dutch Inn. Those attended, and it was standing room only, I might add, had a choice of chicken or prime rib. The good meal was followed by good conversation and lots of dancing to the music of the rustics. One of the many highlights of the evening was the singing of Silent Night, which was done by Ruth Rohn, Mrs. Gatewood, and Mrs. Dobbins, and John Fleming standing in the background. As always, the evening was a big success, and congratulations to them.
Okay, John. And a new tradition was started this year at the Paulsboro Police Department. Invited children from St. John's School to make and place their decorations on the department's Christmas tree located at the station. Of course, the visit included a chance to meet Santa and Mrs. Claus, plus the Christmas angel. Guess who? It was an opportunity for the kids to be at the police station and see the department as part of the holiday spirit. Police Chief Roger DiStefano said that each year a different school of the town's elementary schools will be invited. The tree was donated by You Save Rental, Jack Mazda, and they donated the tree and stand to a needy family in Paulsboro. Beautiful spirit.
It really is, Irma. And keeping along those lines, the Christmas Story Cantata was performed at St. Paul's United Methodist Church by the combined choirs of St. Paul's and the Clonmel Methodist Church of Gibbstown under the direction of Don Crooks. He and his wife were on this show. The 45-voice choir delighted the gathered congregation, and let's listen to a little bit of a sampling.
Thank you.
John, I forgot two happy anniversaries, Cookie and Harry Llewellyn and Mary and Bill McGinnis, 40 years. Also, John, Paulsboro Holiday Tournament Wrestling, Bantams and Tots. Paulsboro High School, December the 29th. It starts from 9 a.m. And John, I don't know if everybody knows it, but Paulsboro High School wrestling team is number 6 in the nation, USA Today. Hello. And this is where our gang started. See, call John Haddock, 423-7975, December 29th. If you don't have anything to do, go out and support our kids. You're going to watch them someday be state champs, John.
Thank you, Reverend. And here's a little different twist. Paulsboro Volunteer Fire Company held a country and western night. The large crowd was resplendent with cowboy hats, boots, and fancy step dances. Music was provided by 90 Proof. Event chairperson Delbert Streeper said the evening was a great success with proceeds going to firehouse projects. And here's a little sampling of country western music by 90 Proof and some fun dancing.
Congratulations, 130-pound teams, with Coach Anthony Canista from Paulsboro. The Gibbstown Tornadoes came to a tie, 6-6, with the Salem group. Anthony's from Paulsboro, and congratulations to our guys, football players. Maybe we'll have some more Kevin Rosses and Flipper Andersons.
They're on the way, Irma. And keeping along the line with Christmas, we go to the Billingsport Firehouse, and as we go there, we see Santa and Mrs. Claus arriving on the back of the big blue fire truck, to the delight of the kids and adults alike. The tradition of this Christmas party goes back over 40 years, making Christmas memories for many generations of fire company members and their kids.
Top Shelf Productions, John, we had those fine gentlemen, that group on. They're going to have a weekend ski trip, February 28th to March the 1st in Massachusetts. Please call Bruce Johnson, 384-0741. Help these guys out. They help our kids in town, John.
And they do. And we continuing again, we've got so much footage this week. The St. John's Mother of Sorrow Society held their Christmas dinner Saturday evening in the church basement. The chicken entree was prepared by Masso's caterers, and each member brought a covered dish. The evening was highlighted with the presentation of a check in the amount of $2,000 to Father McCabe for the church. The money was raised by the ladies through different events held during the year. What an organization that is. And Irma, the Paulsboro Ministerium presented their second annual Christmas program at the high school auditorium on December 18th. This year, choirs from the Second Baptist Church, which is their combined choir, led by Steve Bagwell, St. John's, under the direction of June Senafani, the PHS Student Choir, led by Jim Berkeley, along with the Faith Tabernacle Choir, and a solo by St. Paul's Don Crooks, entertained the large group. A special mention to Reverend Ken Singer, who heads the ministerium this year, and Reverend White, who led the audience in Christmas Carol sing-along, and they had a grand time.
They can sing.
And Paulsboro's been busy around town.
They certainly have, John. I'm still finishing my shopping. How about you, Dominic? Are you still shopping?
No, I'm done shopping.
I'm still shopping. Shop in town.
What else do we have?
John, I would say that's about it, except for finale, I'm going over and sing with my girls and guys over here with the senior citizens.
Well, that's pretty scary. We've got a lot of show coming up. Kid Primo's helping with the co-hosting. The senior citizens have been so gracious to be with us. Marion, if we could have a little music, we'll go to commercial. Another holiday work. Irma's sneaking into the group, and on we go.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
On behalf of the governing body, I'd like to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a very prosperous and safe New Year.
The Plaza Inn, Paulsboro's most popular night spot. Kick off your weekend on the Plaza Inn dance floor with our disc jockeys every Friday and Saturday night, plus live bands throughout the year. And to break up your workday, stop by and enjoy our delicious Plaza Luncheon specials for only $2. It's friendly service and great times. It's the Plaza Inn. Located in the Plaza Shopping Center, West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
And to rent our lounge for private parties, call 423-1024.
Hi, welcome back once again. And I keep mentioning when we come back what a wonderful time we're having. It's cold outside, but it's real warm inside. We're heading into the Christmas season, and each year we always bring a reminder about safety in the house, because here in Paulsboro, even us as a small town, more than a handful of years ago, two children, I think, died in a fire resulting from a Christmas tree. So with us now is John Carrow, who's a dedicated fireman and public servant as well. And John's going to bring us just a couple common sense tips so we can all have a happy holiday. John, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You're no strangers to the show.
But
right to the point, people can die in a fire, and Christmas time is a scary time.
Yes, it is.
the big thing you got to, you know, people's got smoke alarms, make sure they check them, especially, from, you know, make sure they're all working. At night, the weather's cold. A lot of people have fireplaces, and they like to sit around there, especially during Christmas time. Make sure you keep your covers in front, the glass covers. Make sure that your chimney's cleaned. At night, when you go to bed at night, make sure you turn all your lights out, your Christmas lights, because, let's face it, real trees do dry out, and they have a tendency, that's when fire breaks out. Especially the kids, make sure you put your gifts away, because your mom and dad have to come downstairs. We don't need them tripping down a stairway trying to make a rescue. If everybody heard in Clayton just the other day, a parent that was totally blind saved his own family and lost his life. He's a hero in my book. It's a shame we lost him, but because of the family thinking that he the losing his sight, he was able to save his whole family, and that's what it's all about. And everybody will get through Christmas if they think that way.
Thank you, John. John, I understand you're related to Kid Primo. Is that true?
Oh, yeah.
That's John Carrow. They're very, very important tips to remember. Christmas time wants to be a happy time, and we don't want to have John Carrow and the rest of the volunteers called out of the house on Christmas Day. So be very careful. Marion, may we have a little music as we prepare to travel with another Christmas message to follow, and we're going to come right back with another segment.
Baptist Church in Paulsboro would like to wish all of those in Paulsboro and surrounding communities a very, very Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. And we pray that the year 1992 will be prosperous and good for us all in Christ Jesus. Amen.
At the Mount Royal Radio Room, we are the two-way radio and CB specialists with over 20 years' experience. We do on-the-spot repairs, and we carry a complete line of radar detectors, CBs, and antennas for cars to 18-wheelers. See the experts in CB sales and service at Mount Royal Radio Room in the Mount Royal Plaza, adjacent to the 76 truck stop. Call 423-1748.
Let's start high school football 2 or 3 weeks earlier.
Let's face Warfare. It, controversy, Warfare. It creates interest. People are already... In part to you.
Are you saying you like controversy?
People,
why don't you like me? Oh, the poor, poor soccer players. Let them wear long sleeves, sweaters like football players do. I stayed home on Thanksgiving, ate dinner with my wife and daughter, drank a big glass of Tony Port afterwards, and smoked a cigar. And you know what?
They said, what are you doing here, Dad?
Tune in to Sports Week Wednesdays at 7 and 10:30 p.m. on Channel 5.
Hi, we're back again. With me is Kid Primo, who's been behind us through most of the show, and without his accordion today, because the senior citizens have stepped in to help us. Dominic, I wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas.
Same to you, guys.
Now, you've got people at the house, so you're going to leave us while we tape the last couple segments.
Yeah.
Which is going to
so
be hard.
So I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas in the studio and throughout. That's a beautiful. You walk down the street, somebody says, Channel 5. I'm telling you. A lot of people that curse me says, you used to fire and you're still on television. And I'll be 79 in April. Thank God. Let me tell you, I feel beautiful. Keep, and I wish everybody a Merry Christmas here and around the, you know, the area.
Thank you, Dominic. Yeah. Now, Dominic, in the up and coming year, is going to be serving as our political analyst, as well as our accordion player, we hope. Am I right about that, Dominic? He's going to handle all the political analysts
and
commentary.
Well, I was to pitch broken English in South Philly, by the way.
That's Dominic. Kid Primo. We're going to go to Stella Benne. We have a little pre-recorded piece, which we did just before the show on the last one. She's got a hint for us of entertaining, and we always enjoy Stella. And, of course, we know she cooks at the hospital, and what a story that is. Stay with us, Stella Benne, followed by another message, and we're going to come right back. The fun continues.
With me now is Stella Benne, and we always enjoy having Stella on the program. She works for Underwood Hospital, where, of course, the cuisine is renowned throughout the county. And Stella joins us now with another holiday tip on how you can present snacks without sending yourself to the hospital, I suppose. Stella?
Thank you, John.
The candles are a nice touch.
Yes, it's nice to have ambiance.
As is the red hat.
Right, yes. It's my little Santa's hat here.
Shall we start?
Today, we're talking about holiday entertaining tips, and what I have presented here is some vegetables and some low-calorie dip, low-fat dip, and some pretzel chips. Instead of using potato chips, we have these pretzel chips here, very low in fat. 8 of these have 1 gram of fat, whereas about 10 potato chips have about 10 grams of fat. So it's quite a difference calorie-wise. And we have Melba toast chips here, which are nice to dip in, and instead of potato chips again.
And did you make the dip, Stella?
No, it's a salad dressing. You can get any low-calorie or low-fat salad dressing. It's a creamy Italian dressing. It's about 3 grams of fat per tablespoon versus like a sour cream dip, which might be about 5 to 7 grams of fat. So there's a difference there. And vegetables are also high in fiber. We also have, for a snack, maybe instead of corn chips or even cookies or something like that, we have rice cakes, apple cinnamon and honey nut. They're very flavorful and tasty. And it's a good substitute, a lower fat substitute. And we also have some seltzer water with lemon and lime slices. You can use this as a drink substitute instead of alcoholic beverage or instead of soda. It's calorie-free, low in sodium, and you can put some lemon juice in it to flavor it up. And there's also seltzer waters with different flavoring added to them, raspberry, lemon, lime, and orange flavorings. So they taste very good.
Doesn't taste like Johnny Walker.
No, not really.
No, no. So
maybe you can add some of it to it, and then you could decrease the alcohol content of it.
And just decrease the alcohol content. Stella, thank you for joining us.
You're very welcome. Oh, one more thing. Instead of eating chocolate candies, try maybe a little candy cane or peppermint because it's very low in fat, and it's tasty, too.
And I'm sure we're all going to follow Stella's tips, especially through the holidays, and there are some good ones here, especially the seltzer water in place.
Remember, moderation. If you're going to have a high-calorie food, just eat a little bit of it. Just don't go overboard. And enjoy yourself.
Moderation. Thank you, Stella. Always a good sport and fun to have on. We always look forward to our visit. We're going to come right back as we continue with our Christmas special. Stay with us.
Merry Christmas from Benny Sitko.
Happy New Year.
The Italian Villa Restaurant and Deli features delicious homemade favorites with that traditional European flavor. Catering parties any size, and 6-foot hoagies are a specialty too. The Italian Villa Restaurant, 11 Paulsboro Plaza, 423-3325.
Communications Channel 5 presents high school and college basketball. Catch it.
It's with a great deal of pleasure to once again present to you Paulsboro Senior Citizens Club Kazoo Band under the direction of Marion Martino. Marion? Let's hear it for the Kazoo Band. Thank you. The true spirit of Paulsboro.
With me now is Doris Rink, and of course behind me, Bill Crane, our producer, maybe with a wide shot, and Chuck Quackenbush, who's going to have a thank you to come on as we move along here. But now with Doris, our neighbors to Gibbstown, and Doris and Harry are so involved in keeping our cultural alive, our heritage alive. And this year, Doris, you featured, each year you've been featuring a Christmas of a different nation. And tell us about this year.
Okay. Our Greenwich Township Culture and Heritage Committee and its Division of Travel and Tourism each year has a tribute to a special country. And we decorate the North Nagel log cabin in that tradition. And then we have a ceremony with singing, dancing, and some of the traditions that follow. This year, our tribute went to Italy, and that's because of the 500th anniversary of Columbus discovering America. Although that's a celebration for 1992, we wanted to have it in December of 91 to kick it off so we can get everyone familiarized with what the celebration is going to be about during 92.
And you had quite a turnout. Tell us about the event, because Christopher Columbus himself showed up.
Yes, he did. He did. We had found him in a newspaper article several months ago, and it's Dr. Joseph Laufer, and he's a professor at Burlington County College, and he is the official Christopher Columbus impersonator, and he's going all over the United States doing this. And he gave us a nice historical program on Christopher Columbus.
We have to get a few more impersonators on the show after the Andrews sisters tonight, Doris. Now, I enjoyed the accordion band. It was fun.
Yes, that was the Westmont accordion band. And we also had a professional group out of Philadelphia called the Singers and Dancers of Italy.
And a matter of fact, that's a good segue. I'm going to wish you a Merry Christmas to both you and Harry. As we close this segment, we're going to go to some footage and a little bit of music of the dancers as the Greenwich
Township Culture and Heritage
celebrates a Christmas Italian style. Stay with us. We're going to come right back and enjoy this footage.
Hi, we'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year from everybody here at Carol's Diner.
Merry Christmas!
Happy New Year!
Carol's Diner, the diner that makes eating out affordable. Daily breakfast, lunch, and dinner specials. The tea-priced menu at a full portion serving. Plenty of parking, open Monday through Friday, 6 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturday, 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. Carol's Diner, 448 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
The cut on the direct.
Logar right there out in front! Logar! From Scotty Leacock! And the score is tied at 3. Oh, what a game this has been!
Storer Cable and Channel 5, the best in South Jersey sports coverage since 1979.
Hi, and welcome back once again. It's just been a grand time. With me now are two dear friends, and we've only had friends this evening. Of course, we only ever have friends on this program. But with me now is Chuck Quackenbush, who has chaired along with... Oh, excuse me. Well, thank you, Commander Reed.
Very important.
Thank
very
you very
important.
Much, sir. There's a gentleman who understands the term of service to his country.
And helping the show along considerably.
And how sweet it is, as Jackie Gleason used to say. Chuck, just how about a Christmas greeting, and I guess you want to do a thank you.
Well, yeah, I'd like to really express my thanks to everyone in town, particularly Billingsport Fire Company and Paulsboro Fire Company, who really made the parade come off well. We're looking forward to starting up for July 4th the next year.
Not too
soon to start planning already. Especially the people on the committee who helped plan the parade and get everything running. It was just glorious. And I would just want to thank everybody again for getting out and enjoying themselves at the parade.
Thank you, Chuck, and Merry Christmas to you. Chuck Quackenbush and his wife Valerie moved to Paulsboro not too long ago and fell in love with this town, and we're sure glad they came our way because it made a big difference. And on the other side, Judy Gazzara with the last comment about this year's Christmas tree ornament, which, by the way, and we're almost remiss in mentioning, Beth Crane, the Secretary of the Chamber of Commerce, received a request from Governor Florio's wife for a Christmas ornament for the state Christmas tree. So this year's commemorative Christmas ornament is hanging on the state tree in Trenton, and we received a lovely thank you note to that. Judy, a few details quickly.
folks, it's your last chance to get your this year's commemorative Christmas ball. This year's features the high school. It says Paulsboro, home of champions, and a nice winter-looking scene. You can find these at Just For You Sports, Carol's Diner, and Weiss's Department Store.
And there are just a few left. They're soon and destined to become collector's items. That's Chuck Quackenbush and Judy Gazzara, and just two people to help make everything go as far as the Chamber of Commerce and the civic events go that we have. We're going to ask Marion for a little quick traveling music, then we're going to come back with a close, and that'll be pretty special. Stay with us. We're coming to you from the VFW.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Good evening. On behalf of New Beginning Assembly of God, we want to wish the community of Paulsboro a very Merry Christmas and a very joyous New Year. If any of you are looking for a Christmas Eve service and you don't have a home church, we will have a Christmas Eve on Tuesday night at 6 o'clock at 41 Billings Avenue. May God richly bless you. Thank you.
Hi, this is Congressman Rob Andrews, and I'm inviting you to join us on our cable TV town meeting. We'd like you to call in. We'd like to hear from you about taxes, jobs, the economy, education, the environment, senior citizen issues. In order for me to do my job for you in Washington, I need to hear from you. So please, call us, join in. We'd like to hear from you on our cable TV town meeting. Please join us.
Cable TV town meeting, Thursday, January 9th at 8 p.m. live on Channel 5.
Second and 14. Goes deep.
Oh, man, wide open. Wade at the 40, at the 30.
Storer Cable and Channel 5, the best in South Jersey sports coverage since 1979.
It's hard to imagine that our third Christmas special is about to come to a close, but what a wonderful place to have been, and how fortunate we are. Bill Crane, producer, myself, Judy Gazzara, Irma Stevenson, and the regular production gang, and our crew, and Merry Christmas to John Mondelli, our people on the camera, Matt, and Joe and Jim and Rebecca's in the truck, and Stan Ritter back at the office, and Fred Buchter back at the office. We're just very, very grateful. Christmas is a special time, time to take a moment and reflect about our good fortune and to think about how we can help others to make sure that Christmases coming up are also equally special. On a personal note, having my father on the program tonight after his long community service is a great moment of pride for me and our family, and we send our love to him, and we're grateful to him. And a special thank you to my parents. And I can tell you that growing up in a working-class community has meant a great deal to me, and being able to relate and deal with other people through the years. And the one fond memory I carry forward is never, ever having a Christmas that was disappointed. And what a thing to be, that I was disappointed with. And a thank you to my parents. I'm surrounded by about the most lovely people that could ever get in one place at one time. We can't introduce them as time goes, but a thank you to Marion Martino, who's led the senior citizens, all our guests this evening, our host Bob Reed down the end. He's done a wonderful job with the coffee machine tonight, and I think he's going to catch it from Bill Crane when it's over. Chuck Quackenbush and Judy's, I see. And dear Ruth Roan, who tried to sneak away from us. We're going to close the program with a number from this lovely group of senior citizens. A Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all of you. And as we say, from Urban to Bill, we'll see you on Broad Street. Marion?
I'm dreaming of a be one.